jersey, especially based on what happened.
Well, let me say, look, that's out of my hands. My job is to make sure I'm fully prepared to my best of my ability, so I'm 120% or whatever, you know, so I can get in there and I can have some frown punches if need be. I mean, as far as the judges are concerned, all I can do is make sure, like I say, I'm in prime condition and ready for war, and that's out of my hands. I'm not concerned.
Sergio Martinez is a very unorthodox style. How do you do, which he's been very successful and landing power punches from all sorts of odd angles, incredible shots. How do you plan to
I don't want to delve too much into our game plan, which I have been, and we are working on a number of game plans, but I'm convinced that the plan A is going to work. But one thing I will tell you is that, you know, I'm like one of them lizards, I'm a comedian. You know, I can adapt to my surroundings and my opposition. Whatever they bring, I always find a way of sussing out and finding a way to beat them. And you know, like Eddie, my promoter, said, you know, I've captured all these wins and these titles by, you know, at a canter, you know, and these aren't walkovers. And, you know, I'm just going to prove to you guys what I'm capable of doing, and I will find a way to beat them.
Do you think your travelling as an amateur made up for the lack of fighting as a pro outside of, not in the United States? Do you think that's made up for that?
Probably. It's like I said before, you know, I've dedicated my life to boxing, so I think that's a massive facts are here. But one thing I have learned from all them travelling as an amateur was some of the hostile environments. You know, I boxed it, you know, I was, just to name a few, like Hungary, Czech Republic, Russia, you know, where their fans are, you know, you really know you're not at home. And they were some of the toughest hostile conditions I've ever fought in front of, and you know, that put me in good stead for this.
You had other opportunities to take on guys like Afifa, and others. Why take Sergio?
Because I just think, I totally understand that. And like I said before, that I want to prove I'm the best. Everyone wants to prove they're the best, whatever they do. And I just think timing's right. I mean, I've only had the one fight in the year, but I'm looking good at the gym. I won my last fight, you know, as Eddie said, at the Canter against a ranked opponent. And you know, I'm not going to get any younger. I'm 29. I'm not going to get younger. But you know, in saying that, I'm approaching the prime, and I just think timing's right. I just, you know, I fancy fight, and it was Eddie's. You know, wasn't lying when he said that. You know, when I first sat down with him, I said to Eddie, if there's ever the opportunity, you know, the name's ever muttered or Eddie even whispered, just go follow that fight, grab that fight with both hands, because I want it so much. And I want people to understand I'm not here just to make up numbers. I'm here because I believe I can win. I wouldn't put my 17 years of boxing in jeopardy by coming here and getting blown away. I wouldn't do that.
Darren, I really need you to answer this. You're saying the timing is right. What is it about this time? What is it, why is the timing right?
Just, you know, everyone knows their own body and the way they're feeling, and I feel in fantastic condition. You know, it's well documented. I had a hip operation, I'm over that. My body is the best it's been. I feel, if anything, brand new and improved. And I just feel my age, you know, I've got a 7-month-year-old daughter, and the hunger she's given me is a determination to give her everything, you know, just to give her a great life. It's all of that rolled into one is just going to bring out the best of me, you know. When is there a great time? When is there a perfect time to take on the best? But in my head and physically, mentally and physically, I feel right. I feel prepared.
Did you start this thing on Twitter? I mean, did you really get
it? Were you talking about Yeah, no. I'd like to thank Twitter. I'm so glad I signed up. I mean, it was, you know, it was well documented back home. It wasn't like a mad thing I kept going on about. I want to fight Martinez, but you know, I think I see something on there. Would you like to fight Sergio? And I went, look, if the opportunity comes my way, yeah, I would love to. Then it just escalated, and then it finally happened. It was a dream come true. But
who sent the first one?
I think someone who follows Sergio sent me a tweet saying, would you like to fight Sergio?
Not one of the promoters or something?
No. It was a fan or a friend or someone, I'm not sure. And of course, straight away I said yes.
Darren,
Mike Nannon,
Mike Nannon, first off, I welcome.
Thank you very much.
Always a pleasure to have the Englishman.
Ah, thanks.
I know you're from Carl Crock, got a stable mate over there. Well, I heard you make reference there to the story of Rocky.
Yeah.
Talking to you and seeing up there, the confidence level seems much more than a club fighter just getting shot. Can you You seem very, very confident that you have the style to beat Martinez. Can you elaborate at all on the weaknesses that you've seen?
It's very tough to pick out weaknesses, but it's just something, I'm looking at my pluses, and if anything, I've been looking at my weaknesses, how to slide it up myself. But like I said before, I'm like one of them lizards, a chameleon. I sort of change with my surroundings, and I've always found a way to suss out my position. And Sergio's a fantastic fighter, but I've seen weaknesses, not so much as Sergio, but in the opponent's game plans who have fought him recently, which I don't want to go too much into because it goes with my game plan. But I know exactly what I need to do, and I would do nothing. I would hate nothing more than to come out here and say all of this, and for people to think I believe it. I truly believe I'm going to cause an upset here. I'm not crazy or anything like that. I've been boxing for 17 years now. 17 years, I've dedicated my life to it. I know that Sergio started when he was around 20. When he was, from 12 years old, probably younger than that, up to 20. I've been sweating in gyms and getting caught and learning my trade whilst he's been cycling and playing football. I've dedicated my life to this sport, and I just think I'm going to prove to all of you guys, first and foremost, Darren Barker.
Now, you made reference to his points.
Yeah.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
After seeing Paul Williams fight the other day, and again, Kelly Pavlov, he was really good at practice. Do you feel that the opponents that he's beaten have been, would you say they were formidable enough to put him in the position of being called the third best fighter in the world?
I'm not going to take nothing away from their opponents, because they are good fighters, but I think it's the way they approached the fight with Sergio was just wrong. And I've watched them, and I'm just like that, watching them, take on certain things they were doing. But look, he's in that position for a reason, regardless of what you're going to say about the opposition, he's there because he deserves to be. And I just want to prove to myself, to my family, to the fans, what I'm capable of doing.
We've heard a lot about Darren Barker, the fighter here.
Yeah.
Now, can you make reference to this? What inspired you over the 17 years? What was your motivation?
Well, it changed, to be honest, throughout the years. I started boxing initially to make my father proud. My dad was a boxer. He'd retired. He only an amateur, but he won the national title. And I think as any young kid, you want to make your parents proud, and I wanted to make my father proud. So that was my real inspiration. But as time went on, I started getting, quite good at it. I started doing it because I enjoyed winning. I loved winning. And then obviously, when my brother passed away, it was I really wanted to do it for him, for the both of us, for something. Because my brother was more naturally gifted than I am. He was, a real special talent, and like I said before, through my success, his name will continue to live on. And then since I'll always be fighting for my brother, but even more recently, I've had my little baby daughter, and I want the best for her. I want to give her everything possible from life. And through me doing well, she can get that.
Now, as we know, England has an amazing history of boxing. It's put boxing on the map, probably even more so than America in the history of the sport. How does it feel now, going through the whole amateur ranks, now being at the pinnacle of the sport in London? What's that feeling like?
Well, it's a proud moment. I mean, I'm only halfway here at the minute, though. This is only halfway there. I've got to get in there and do it yet. But, one day, I'm not want to get too caught into this now, but one day when I retire, I'll look back at this and think, that was unbelievable. Like I said, I've not just done it just because I enjoy doing it. I've dedicated my life to it. The discipline that, everyone knows, the discipline a fighter has to show to be the best is unbelievable. And, I've really dedicated my life to this. And to be here, sitting here now with, one of the best pound-for-pound fighters and the number one middleweight champion, on top here, looking over at New York, it makes all that hard work worthwhile.
We wish you a lot of luck.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Cheers. Thank you.